this reaction right here, so far, I would have to say, has been my most highly anticipated. Yeah, my most highly anticipated reaction so far. Mariah Carey, Anytime You Need a Friend, live. I've done the music video, but I haven't done a live version. I like to do that. I want to do one music video, at least one version live. You know, you can see the differences. Like I say, you can feel the artist's emotion behind this song different in a live version, just by the way they sing it. They don't ever sing 100% the way they sing it in the music video, the studio version. It never comes out that way, 100%. You can have a live singer sing something 8 times, and every single time it's going to be a little different. They're not going to sing the exact same way every time, and that's how you get that feel, you know? You get to feel what the artist is feeling in that moment while they're singing the song. But anyway, Mariah Carey, Anytime You Need a Friend, no further ado, let's get into the video. Just the way the choir comes in, I think, honestly, besides the climax of the song, that has to be my favorite part. Just hearing the choir come in together initially in the beginning of the song. Man, come on, let's not need that again. Hey, I'm not gonna lie. By the way, the choir is swaying in the back, the step they have, and that they're in the dark. If they hit the climax, not the climax, but they hit the what is it called? The hook. If they hit the hook of the song and the lights come on, and it just feels, if it all comes together correctly the way I think it is, I might lose my mind. I'm not gonna be honest. I might take it there. Just remember to keep your faith. Ooh. And love will be there to light the way. Oh yeah! I will be here. You'll never be alone again. So don't you fear. Even if you're miles away, I'm by your side. Woo. So don't you ever be lonely. I wonder. The thing that you hear that I like about a choir is you hear everybody collectively together, but you can still pick out like 2 or 3 voices. And I wonder how that happens. Is it just someone singing louder than everyone else? Is it just the way the mics are placed? Or is it like some weird scientific thing, you know, where all the voices come together and one just gets pushed out harder than the other just because of, I don't know, the pressure of the voices or whatever. I wonder how that happens. But that, yeah, it was everything like I thought it was with the lights. Okay, it wasn't everything I thought it was. I thought the lights were just gonna turn on. I didn't even think for the lights to flash like that when they came in. That was smart. That was different. I didn't even expect that. And I didn't expect all the different colors too. I like this type of stuff, this planning. The back, it's very interesting to think about the planning, the background, the how you want things to be done during the performances. All that's, I think as a fans, we don't take account how much work is done into putting in a concert. From the simplest thing to the most exquisite stuff, we don't take in the planning beforehand. How is this going to work? All the testing, all the rehearsals. I don't think we really consider that when we sit down and watch someone perform. We just take in the finished product, but it's nice to go back to think about it, so you really get appreciation for the hard work that these people do. But anyway, let's go. So don't you fear, even if you're
Man, that choir right there.
When the shadows are closing in, and your spirit
Oh, my spirit is so diminished. It's so diminished.
But we back up. Anyway, I think another reason why I enjoy this song so much is because, like I've told you guys in previous songs, I enjoy her chest voice. I love her chest voice. It seems like the majority of the song is saying in that range, in her natural chest voice. And I enjoyed it. I enjoyed listening to it so much. And the emotion, the passion she puts behind her singing, you can feel it. Like, listen to how she sang Spirit. You feel that. I ain't catch it at all.
In your spirit. Diminishing. Just remember, you're not alone, no, 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 and love will be there.
Turn it up, choir.
God, I need that. Whoa, way better than the studio version. And I don't think it's just because of the way that they sang it. I just think because it's a studio version. It has that little computer, that little, the touch of technology in it where it takes just an of humanity out of it, right? You can't have both. You can't be heavily, what is it called? What did you put in? Mechanic size? I don't even know what but you can't have a lot of technology input and still have a lot of humanity input. You're going to, it doesn't go together. It doesn't, that's why I like live versions. This is why I like live versions. That build up, way better than the studio version. Like I said, not because there's anything wrong with the studio version, but it's because you get more of that human touch, that human aspect in it. You start to feel that, and just listen to the build up. What did I press?
Take me to the heart, and baby, I'll be there forever, baby. I won't let go. I'll never let go.
Oh my God! Help me! Oh, they cut the music out. I didn't even realize. It's better than what I could have imagined. They took the music out.
I'm sitting here singing all wide mouth and gap tooth, and I didn't even catch it. Whoa. Before we get into the remix part, did y'all catch the people in the choir? Some of the people in the back room go, oh, just put in just a little bit of two cents of ad lib. This is a, is this a little? I needed this in my life. I had a heart last week. But, talk about a pick-me-up. Wow. Talk to me. I need that whole thing again.
Did you ever be lonely? Did you ever be lonely? Did you ever be lonely? Lonely, 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 lonely. Did you ever be lonely?
Hold on. Was the queen of remixes, and I didn't see this coming. Would you ever be lonely? I thought it was some club music, right? And then she brought the whole song into it. Genius. Now, did she? I know y'all said if she sang it, she wrote it. But did she come up with this idea on her own? Did she get help? Everybody on this whole team gets an A+ for me. Production, the people who thought it up. Mariah, the background singers, every single person that had the tiniest, even down to the custodians that was cleaning up after, everybody got an A+ from me, man. This is brilliant. And she leaving there. And she's leading it. It all comes together smooth. It comes together nice. What the dance is?
I never for a million years thought that Mariah Carey would have a song where she got background singers.
Maybe someday. But overall, I never saw it coming.
It would have been tough if she was still leading the song going upstairs.
And that's how you need a friend. Whoa, I will.
Yeah, that's how you end it. Y'all see why it's my favorite Mariah Carey song. I think mostly because of the chest voice that she's in most of the time throughout the song. That's why I love it so much. But wow, talk about queen of remixes. That was a remix that I did not see coming. I enjoyed this whole reaction. I think I don't really have too much to say now because I feel like I said everything throughout the video. But if you made it to this point, I thank you. It's going to be ready for a reaction. If you enjoyed the reaction, make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe. Be with you guys next time. I'm out.